Thank you, Mehdi. Thank you for being there. So my name is François Lecara. I am IT strategy director for FM Logistic. My job is to build an information system aligned with the strategy of the company. And I will try to explain to you how we are building this information system and how we met APIs and why we met APIs. So FM Logistic is a company, it's too fast, okay, a company of transport, supply chain, warehousing and co-packing. We are in 13 countries, 14 because Vietnam is open last week. Almost 22,000 employees in the world. What we did, it's an audit of our information system. What the major message is, we try to align the information system of on the strategy of our company. And we did an audit with some key conclusions. The major conclusion is our information system was not aligned with the strategy. So we took some key decision, and this decision concern transverse information IS foundations, the opening of information system, the internal flows, and so on, and several topics where APIs help us to modernize our information system and to be aligned with the strategy of the company. So today there are some projects, we are leading some projects to modernize our information system. First of all, we are speaking about master data management. We are organizing our data. You will see in the architecture of our information system the role, the positioning of our data. So we are working on the master data of our information system about customers, about plans, and so on. Second, exchanges. And we will speak about APIs in this great project to share, promote data usage, to open our information system to the ecosystem. One of the major issue for our information system was that our information system was too focused internally. So we decided to open this information system, and you will see how we will do it. We call AIM. Today we have some context with issues about security, cyber security. So we are working on identity and access management. We want to open our information system to our ecosystem, but we want to secure this openness. After, don't remember, collaborative platform. In fact, you see that we want to open our information system. We want to develop the collaboration between all the actors of the ecosystem. But we need to give some tools. And we are implementing a collaborative platform. It's Jalios for FM Logistic. Today, we are able to have on the same platform somebody from Sao Paulo in Brazil, or someone in Shanghai in China. So this is the target architecture. It's not technical. I am not a technical guy. So what I want to explain to you, it's what we call and what we try to build as a collaborative supply chain. So at the center, you see the data, the foundations, the silos, warehousing, transport, co-packing, and finance, HR, and so on. And you have the APIs catalog. We are developing some APIs to open our information system to our ecosystem. And we are doing some, what we call, vertical collaboration. And you see on the top the providers. And down, I don't know if you see down, but there is the customer. So we are able to do this kind of collaboration, vertical collaboration, between the providers and the customers. And you have a second kind of collaboration, thanks to APIs, horizontal collaboration between partners or competitors. So our information system will be able to support these two kinds of collaboration, thanks to APIs. Some components to be more concrete. So this is our architecture, our target. We have some components like cloud, like Internet of Things, like mobile apps. So these are components that have an impact on our infrastructure. And we have some peripheral applications. Stock booking is a marketplace where which aligns the demands on empty spaces in our warehouses. We have Shipeo, which is a collaborative tracking solution for connecting all the actors of transport. And we have last but not really the last, it's called City Login. City Login is a concept, a solution of ecological logistics for the cities. So this is our information system with some peripheral modules. What are the next steps to continue this building? First of all, API management. So we are creating, building some APIs, but we need to manage better than we do actually, because we have an increasing number of APIs, and we need to manage this number. Second, we need to continue the integration of cloud, Internet of Things, mobile, and so on, because these have an impact on our information system. After urbanization, we need to redesign our information because we have a legacy, we have a historical information system, and we need to merge with digital digital components. So we need to redesign the information system. Big data, we need to, you saw that data are at the center of the ecosystem. We are data centric, and we need to exploit better the data to optimize our internal processes and to offer new services to our customer. And to finish, digital workplace. I spoke about ecosystem, and what we want to do with what we call digital display, digital workplace, is what we call anytime, anywhere, any device, any content. We want to, for each member of the ecosystem, to access to the data necessary to his role in the ecosystem. So there will be this digital workplace. To finish, to conclude, what are our challenges, and APIs will help us to achieve these challenges. First of all, new services. Before, Eric Ballot spoke about the physical internet. We are working with him on this topic. There is artificial intelligence, blockchain, real time, because you see that if you want to have the right information, we need to work on this topic. Control tower. We need to control, because if we open the information system to the ecosystem, we need to control how we open this control, this information system. Security. Ah, yes, thanks. Security. We work on security, because for us, the opening can't be done without working on security. So this is a topic we think about security in each project we lead in the company. And to finish, sustainability. We work on it because we think that tomorrow we must have a green logistics. So we work on sustainability. And you see that I wrote digital transformation and collaborative supply chain. We think that APIs can help us for digital transformation and for collaborative supply chain. And I think without APIs, we can't do digital transformation. Thanks.
We have time for one question, because every time I say that, we have a great question. So.
Yes, thank you very much. I want to know if you said you were serving a strategy, because the API and the opening of this IT system is serving a strategy. And when we are talking about platforming, opening, then there is also the issue about sharing value in a different way with your partners, with your customer. Is it part of the strategy, and is it an issue?
It's completely a part of our strategy. When I speak about collaborative supply chain, it's the speech of our general manager. And we want to achieve this target of our strategy. It's written in our strategy. You saw at the beginning that we have a strategy called Ambition 2022. It's written in this strategy to create this ecosystem and to collaborate with all the actors of the ecosystem.
Great. Thank you very much, François Descartes. Thank you.
Thanks.